What is up? I am Doug, and welcome to Kingdom Hearts, my stream. So what I do is I stream video games and I upload them to YouTube. Stream them on Twitch, upload them to YouTube. And I've been doing a series of Kingdom Hearts videos. My first set of videos was Final Fantasy, but I decided to take a break because I really wanted to get into Kingdom Hearts, because Kingdom Hearts 3 has actually just come out, and I wanted to beat the game, the series, before 3 came out so I could stream the series and all that fun stuff, and obviously that didn't happen. Life ensued, projects take longer than you would think, and here we are, starting Kingdom Hearts 2. When I finished up Chain of Memories, which was like the last series of videos that I recorded, the last game, I mentioned that I was going to be doing the entire series and putting Kingdom Hearts 3, like my own personal playthrough, off until we got to Kingdom Hearts 3, like in the series on my channel. So basically I'd play through 2 and then Birth by Sleep, Kingdom Hearts Days, Rechain of Memories, 2.8 Collection, a bunch of games, basically, before I played Kingdom Hearts 3. I kind of broke that promise. I got the game, from, you know, the story I pre-ordered it from, came home, and the temptation was too great. I just plugged it in, and I played it straight over the weekend, and I've beaten the game, so, I'm kind of playing through this game with not only the knowledge of what happens later in the franchise, but also what happens in the finale of this saga of Kingdom Hearts, of like the whole story starting with Kingdom Hearts 1 all the way to 3. I'll explain more about it as we go, because I don't want to waste too much time on this like intro spiel, but you know, I love talking about this kind of things. This is just fun for me. But, as I was playing through Kingdom Hearts 3, like, there were a lot of times when I was like, wow, I really wish I had my camera so I could record my initial reaction to this. But there were often a lot of times where I was kind of glad it was, like, you know, just a personal, intimate moment for me. Because, you know, I started playing this game, these games, long before I, actually, you know, could even dream about recording it or sharing it online. So, you know, I was happy that I got to have my own personal experience with it. And I also thought that for every time that I wish I, you know, had a camera to talk about what I was feeling and, like, sharing that with another person, I realized I'd probably feel much better if I come back to it after I had beaten the series and beaten the game at least once, so I could kind of just digest the game, and that's kind of what I'm doing now. Like, I'm processing my feelings of Kingdom Hearts 3, even as we speak. Like, I've been thinking about the game ever since I finished it. Like, I still haven't been able to, like, you know, like, I might have put the controller down and finished the game and stopped it there, but, really, when it comes down to it, I've kind of decided that I'm happy, like, basically, I'm still thinking about the game, still. Like, every night I think about it going to bed, like, how I feel, and it's definitely something, like, going back, and I think it's nice that I am playing Kingdom Hearts 2, because this is my favorite, or was my favorite game in the franchise. I don't know how it stacks up to 3 right now, and I'm probably gonna have a more, like, solidified feeling once I finish this game of, like, what do I think is, like, the better game, technically. I'll just say I really love 3. It's probably gonna be divisive, with the community. I can already see that. I liked it a lot. I mean, there were some things that did kind of frustrate me about the game, that I wish they could have done things differently with the narrative and how some characters were handled. But ultimately, I thought it was a really good game. Like, not just, like, you know, in terms of, like, being this huge, big, like, end of an era thing. The thing I liked about it a lot was that it was very much just a solid video game. Like you could pick it up and play it and have a fun time not having played the other games before. And I think that's a really cool thing. And basically, I've just been rambling on and on about this, so Basically, I played Kingdom Hearts 3. I really loved it, and now I want to play Kingdom Hearts 2. Also, so, like, I'm going to do my best not to spoil anything for Kingdom Hearts 3, because I know how upset I was when some things were spoiled, and they were just relatively minor spoilers. Spoilers I predicted, but I didn't want to have confirmed the way that they were. So, you know, I'm going to avoid a lot of the spoilers. A lot of the spoilers probably don't even make sense in context of Kingdom Hearts 2. That's just, like, how the narrative has developed throughout the franchise. But still, I'm going to avoid Kingdom Hearts 3 spoilers, spoilers for the other games. Maybe if I really feel the need to talk about something, if, like, I think there's, like, a clever or, like, an interesting theme or something, I might take, like, a segment at the end of a stream to talk about it, but I'm going to do my best to, you know, broadcast in advance that I'm talking about something spoilery. But it's going to be a long time coming, basically, with Kingdom Hearts 3 in terms of my planning for that. Like, when I sat down and thought about it, like, because I, like, debated for, like, an hour if I should play Kingdom Hearts 3 on my own or just, you know, start streaming and recording, too. Because, like, that was what I was going to do that day because, there was a really bad blizzard, polar vortex, I guess is the technical term, last week where, like, all my college classes got canceled, and I just was thinking, okay, you know, this is perfect time for me to record. I can knock out at least half of Kingdom Hearts 2 and then spend at least, like, a day or two just processing and recording the videos. But then I, you know, when I, but I had to pick up my copy of the game, and, like, I was holding it, and I was like, I could play this, no, I could play Kingdom Hearts 2, and I was just debating constantly, and I realized it's going to take a while to beat all of the Kingdom Hearts games. Like, Chain of Memories was a very quick experience. Like, in total, it took only a couple hours. Like, and I think in total it wound up being, like, 20 hours of game time, give or take. Like, and that just felt like a long process. Like, not as long as, like, Kingdom Hearts 1 felt, I'd say, but still, and 2 is a very meaty game, and also, Kingdom Hearts 2 has a lot of endgame content. Like, so much that, like, even I haven't completed. Like, Kingdom Hearts 1 and Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories, I've done everything there's to do in those games. I've done all the Olympus Coliseum matches, I've done all the bonus bosses, I've, like, you know, used and collected every card, all that fun stuff. But I haven't done the same with Kingdom Hearts 2, because there's a lot that they added, for 2, and also a lot they added in the Final Mix Remastered Edition. So, like, basically, there was just so much I wanted to do, and I felt that if I had kept Kingdom Hearts 3, like, my first playthrough off till later, I would have been just rushing through the game. Like, my honest thought process was I was going to play Kingdom Hearts 2 and then just skip the endgame content. Like, and maybe do one of the bosses that has something to tie into the story, but I don't want to do that. Like, I want to, you know, have fun and just have, like, an organic replay of the game instead of trying to, I guess, like, speed through it. Like, in trying to just give, like, you know, the Cliff Notes version. I want to show, like, all the fun little minutiae and take my time, because these games are so much fun when you take your time. So, and not only that, like, I would be rushing through the rest of the franchise. Like, this, I can take my time playing through the games, while still having the enjoyment of playing Kingdom Hearts 3. I guess, like, you know, this is my way of justifying, because, like I said, I thought a lot about this. And these are, like, my thoughts of why I decided to play Kingdom Hearts 3 now instead of waiting. And basically what this means now is, like, I can play Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix in all of its entirety, not skipping any of, like, the bonus bosses, like, the extra mini-games and everything. Like, really getting into the meat of the game and taking my time with it and having fun. And also, this means I can do some other projects on the side. Like, I've been really putting off playing Persona 5, like, for a while now, actually. And, the chance to, you know, maybe do that concurrently, like, at least start that a little bit, and we'll see how Kingdom Hearts 2 goes, because I don't want to divide myself between two projects, but, like, this means that I can start Persona 5 a lot sooner, because I've been waiting to do that for, like, a couple months now. And also, this means that, with the, because there are two, Kingdom Hearts games that, are DS titles, and all they've done for like the remaster was just remaster their cutscenes. This way I can hopefully get my hands on a capture card somehow, or if not that, you know, figure out some like other way to play the game and record them and mix in like the remastered cutscenes, so that way I can actually get across the experience of playing the games, as well as like the updated, you know, story content. So that way I can like share that aspect of it and like my own like I don't know what to say, like the best word for that would be like my own experiences and feelings on that. So like basically this is just like some like 10-minute long rant about why I'm deciding to do Kingdom Hearts 3 before this, and not like it matters, you know, like there's maybe been like a break in my content upload thing, and I'm pretty sure I lost my momentum on Twitch, because they have like trophies for beating the game at a certain pace or anything, so, or not like beating games, but like streaming over a certain period of time. So yeah, basically that's just that, because you know, I have a pretty small subscriber base, don't have a lot of people watching my content, so in a lot of way these videos are like my own private journals of like, you know, gaming and experience and stuff, and it's just like this really weird project of mine that is constantly ongoing, and I just wanted to, I guess, get my thoughts across and how I feel and my justification for things and everything. So enough about that. We need to start Kingdom Hearts 2, and I realized something, that my face box is in the wrong corner, so the screen's gonna go blue for a second while I fix that. Okay, we're good. We are fixed. Alright, so, Kingdom Hearts, Chain of Memories, or Rechain of Memories, had a very overwhelming, heads-up display. You had your, HP down in this corner. Well, no, you had your HP up in this corner, you had the enemy HP up in that corner, you had your deck of cards in this corner, and then you had the enemy deck of cards in this corner. So there was like no good place to put my like face box. So I just kind of found like the area where I would be sacrificing the least for it, and decided to put my face in front of the enemy cards, which didn't affect it too badly, because whenever an enemy plays a card, you see it in the middle, and enemies would shuffle their decks constantly, and it was mostly only the bosses you had to worry about. So like I still had my HP, my deck, and the enemy's HP. This time it's a lot easier to deal with. Your command menu is in the bottom left corner, your HP along with your allies is in the bottom right corner, and enemy HP is in the top right corner, and left top corner, nothing to worry about. So face is now back in the box, where in the corner where it belongs. I'm happy personally with that. Because, like, I like to, I mean, if you watch any of my videos, you can kind of see that, hey, I look up at my face a lot to see, you know, if I look okay, and where my eye contact is and everything, and so it's nice that I can do that a little bit easier instead of trying to have to peer up and look in the bottom corner of the screen all the time. And, like, I noticed when I was doing my little rant there that I ended up, I was just like, oh crap, the box is in the wrong corner, am I gonna have to restart this whole thing? And I just decided to do the blue screen, and I'll say I edited it, but I won't. I don't edit it, really. So anyways, Kingdom Hearts 2, final mix. So as we can see, we've got Sora, and we've got some, like, Sora. If you watch the, if you watch my last, series, Kingdom Hearts 3 Chain of Memories, you'll know that guy from the endings of both. He appeared at like the end credit scene, so he is presumably an important character. I already kind of know that already. Anyone who's played this game kind of knows that. But yeah, he's featured primarily alongside Sora, and he's actually one of my favorite characters, so I'm looking forward for everyone to get to know him. So kind of similar to Kingdom Hearts 1, we've got three basic modes: beginner, standard, and proud. And then we've got critical mode. So beginner mode, easy mode essentially. This is you can't unlock the secret ending in this mode, only the normal ending. In standard mode, it's a balance mode. It's not too hard, not too easy. Very much the medium. All endings can be viewed in this mode. You can unlock the secret ending, but it's the hardest to unlock. Like, you basically have to do everything in the game, like 100% it completely, which is kind of exhausting. Then there is proud mode, a difficult mode with stronger enemies, best for those seeking a challenge. In the original Kingdom Hearts 2, that was the Kingdom Hearts 2 that was released on the PlayStation 2 way back when, I think it was like 2006. This was the hardest difficulty. There's a good chance of unlocking the secret ending. It's easier to unlock the secret ending in this one. Easier than standard mode, but not as easy as critical mode. This was added in the Final Mix versions. Final Mix was initially released in Japan, I think like a year or two after the first game came out. It wasn't released in the West, but it had the option of English like dialogue, so people could like import it and still like understand what was being said. And also I think like some people like patched the game themselves and like were able to replace the dialogue boxes with English and everything. But for it was really difficult to play up until they re-released the games on the PlayStation 3 for the 2.5 remix, which contained this game, Birth by Sleep, and Kingdom Hearts Recoded. So critical mode, it's like the super hard mode, or very hard, or whatever. It's critical. It's harder than proud. It's a true test of skill, beginning with certain abilities and other perks. Basically, playing on critical mode, you have the easiest chance of unlocking the secret ending. Like, you still have to do a fair amount, because there's like two secret endings for this game. So you have an easier chance of unlocking both secret endings. But the game is extremely hard. Enemies do a lot more damage. You can go down really quickly. Like, bosses can really kick your butts. And they do offset that, though, by giving you access to a lot of abilities right at the beginning of the game. You gain a lot of AP and you gain a lot of abilities. I was kind of going back and forth on what I wanted to do, if I wanted to do critical or proud mode, simply because I was thinking what would be the easiest way for me to unlock the secret ending, that doesn't require me doing a bunch of extra pointless content, and I kind of decided that I want to go with proud mode. Critical mode is, like, I think a difficulty that I want to tackle another time. Like, maybe some day down the line I'll do a critical mode run, like, I don't know. Maybe if I ever want to replay this game. I want to do it on my own first, so that way I know what I'm getting into. I've done standard mode, I did a proud mode run that I was kind of proud of. But I feel like this is, like, a good balance, because you still have to do a lot of the content to get the bonus endings. And that works out for me pretty well. And because I'm not in a rush anymore, I'm okay with, like, the requirements of unlocking the secret ending for proud mode. When I wanted to get through it quickly, I was really considering critical mode, and then I looked at they basically had the... They don't have the same requirements, but very similar. So yeah, we're going with, proud mode. One thing about critical mode, though, is that, one of the abilities that you have unlocked is EXP Zero, which basically means that you don't get any experience. I don't know if it's in proud or standard mode. I don't really pay attention. It's an ability I never use, but I know it's in critical mode, and it's like if you want the ultimate challenge, like that's what that's for. So we're gonna start with proud mode. We're gonna turn vibration functions on. Also, they're not gonna ask you about camera controls in this game, because this was the first game that had like a more modern action RPG kind of like control system with like the thumbsticks and all that stuff. I'm going to be quiet here because opening movie's about to start. And usually what that means is that the audio for this is probably going to get muted. Maybe not if I'm lucky. It's just the weird way Twitch and its copyright rules work. And there's also a possibility that some of my dialogue after the fact could get muted because it's like I had this issue with reaching the memories the last episode actually. So what I'm gonna do is basically we're gonna play the opening movie, watch that, and then I'm gonna end the stream and restart it so that way I can get my dialogue through it every way. Anyways, enjoy. I'll be back in a sec.
Scattered dream that's like a far-off memory. A far-off memory that's like a scattered dream. I want to line the pieces up. Yours and mine.
This is the part where we go away because there's actually some story content here. The arbitrary restrictions that Twitch puts on me and the things I go through to make sure you guys can experience content. First off, I love that opening movie, so fair use, I'm critiquing it, but anyways, here's the story stuff. We'll
You have arrived. I've been to see him. He looks a lot like you. I'm what's left. Or maybe I'm all there ever was. My name is of no importance. What about you? Do you remember your true name?
Sora? Give me a break, I.
Giving up already? If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one?
This world has been connected.
What? Who's there?
Tied to the darkness.
Sora, don't ever change.
The door has opened.
What?
You understand nothing.
Sora.
Another dream about him.
My favorite world. First day.
Man, doesn't that tick you off?
Yeah, that's just wrong.
The cipher's gone too far this time.
I mean, it's true that stuff's been stolen around town, and we've got a score to settle with Cipher and everything. So, if he wants to think we did it, I can't really blame him. See, that's not what really bugs me. What really bugs me is that he's going around telling everybody we're the thieves. Now the whole town and their mothers are treating us like the Klepto Club. Have you ever been this ticked off before in your life? Because I haven't. Nuh-uh. Never. Now, what to do?
We could find the real thieves. That would set the record straight. Hey, that sounds fun.
What about Cypher?
First, we gotta clear our names. Once we find the real culprit, everyone will get off our backs.
Oh no! They're gone! Are gone! What?
All are gone?
You can't say why not?
But you do understand what I'm saying, right? Our are gone.
Stolen. And not just the word. They stole it, too.
What kind of thief is that? Cypher could never have pulled that off.
Yeah.
All right, time for some recon.
Huh?
His heart is returning. Doubtless he'll awaken very soon.
Roxas, come on!
Over here! Move the left stick to make Roxas run. Tilt it slightly to make Roxas walk. Jump with circle. Approach the armor shop. If you can't remember what to do next, press the options button to confirm your objective. Like that. So yep, this is Kingdom Hearts 2. Starting the game off boldly with a new character and a new world and everything's weird. Yeah, so this is Roxas. Those are his friends. Some guy named Cypher doesn't like them and everyone thinks they're thieves. And also someone's stolen photos, and not only just photos, but the actual word photo. Like, they can't say it, but they know what they're saying, they just can't verbalize it. Which, it's kind of funny and weird. And like, as a kid, I did not get that at first. Like, it confused the heck out of me. So, I'm explaining it now, because you could probably understand it, but I didn't. I just want to be sure everyone can understand it. By skimming the sides of buildings, you can grab the edge and pull yourself up. Try it for access to various places. Let's get this investigation underway. Yo, Roxas. Never thought you'd do such a rotten thing. We didn't steal anything, alright? I'd like to believe you, but who else would steal that stuff? What stuff? As if you don't know. Hey, I'm not gonna tell you. Go ask at the accessory shop. Go on, Roxas. Ask her. I've been having a hard time with my consonants and it's bugging me a little bit. Reaction commands are used to execute actions according to situations. Approach the accessory shop and use the talk reaction command will appear. Press triangle to use the command. Talk to the accessory shop owner. I'm going to talk to everyone else first. The best way to get info is to ask. Talk to as many people as you can. The promoter of the struggle battle sure works people hard. It's hard work putting up posters. Tram Common is huge. Okay. If you find any interesting looking places in town, check them out too. You may discover some good info. Let's talk to the lady at the accessory shop and begin our investigation. You need money to buy items. If you ever need some cash, you should check the job board here. You currently can't do. I don't know why I'm doing this right now. I just kind of want to run around and play. So yeah, there's some story to do. I'm just kind of playing around. So yeah, this is a Twilight Town, which as you can see, it's honestly bigger than the rest of... I think it's one of the biggest, like, uninterrupted maps in Kingdom Hearts so far. Like, we kind of had, like, you know, there were some big areas before, but they were kind of broken up by loading screens. This is called Tram Common, and it's actually fairly big. It's also kind of fun seeing Trim Common now, because you revisit it in Kingdom Hearts 2. I mean, 3. And it's, like, changed so much, but not in some ways, so I just kind of wanted to run around and get a feel for it and everything. Alright. Enough playing around. Let's talk to the accessory shop. Looks like it's just earrings, mostly. Oh, hello, Roxas. Reaction commands appear in various situations and are very helpful. Use reaction commands whenever possible. So, it's not only how you talk and interact with people, like you use it to open save points, treasure chests, and you can use them in combat, which is where they're most useful. It's kind of similar to Kingdom Hearts 1, but this is the game that introduced the concept. Kingdom Hearts 1.5 adapted it, basically. Like, it was like what they did for the remix. Oh, it's you, Roxas. Please don't let me down. You used to be one of my favorite customers. I'm not a thief! Okay. It's no fun having everyone suspecting me, you know? Then you've got to find a way to clear your name. The woman at the candy shop is pretty disappointed, too. A regular store in a Kingdom Hearts games? Crazy. Roxas? Have you seen my cat around? Meow. Move the camera with the right stick. Press the R3 button to return to its default position. Press R1 to lock onto specific things. When locked onto something, the camera will automatically follow the target. Lock onto the cat. Where could that cat be? It'd be funny if it was somewhere real close. I don't think it would go too far. Have you checked this area carefully? Look around carefully. You might find something. When investigating, don't overlook anything. Locking on is useful when following a target. The camera can be controlled while locked on. Press R1 again to cancel. Thank you, Roxas. Did they steal something from you, too? Oh my, yeah, something important. I'm sorry, this is like the worst old woman voice I've ever had to make. Just so you know, we didn't do it. I believe you! Thanks for that, ma'am. So what did they take from you? My precious! Looks like the culprit is going around stealing. And not just... But the word... Oh wait, no, that's Alette. But the word... This isn't your average thief. I wonder if Cypher would know anything about this. We gotta talk to him, come on, to the Sandlot. The Sandlot. Like the movies, I guess.
Low, you know?
Oh, yeah?
Nice comeback there, Blondie.
What'd you say?
You can give us back the... now.
Yeah, you're the only ones who would take it, you know?
That was undeniable proof that we totally owned you, lamers.
Really good dialogue here. So what did you do?
Burn it? Not that we need some... to prove that you're losers.
Replay.
Now you're talking. I guess if you get on your knees and beg, maybe I'll let it slide.
Roxas!
It's funny because, like, the cutscene implies, like, you know, there's, like, you only have a moment to choose, but you can just talk to everyone, which we're going to do. The weapon on the right's not bad. You can use it in struggle, too, so it should be easy to fight with. Watch your opponent well. When he lets his guard down, strike back. If you do that, you'll be sure to win. If I were you, I'd go with the weapon in the middle. Cypher has to pay. Cypher won't waste time taking you guys seriously, you know? He only uses the most powerful attack when in trouble, you know? Did I sound tough? Did I? Tough like- So, you're feeling up to it? Take your time picking a weapon. So yeah, this is Cypher, Rai, I want to say her name starts with a K. These guys are from Final Fantasy VIII. They were like, I think like the rival characters to Leon from Kingdom Hearts 1. Squall in that game. And this is Vivi from Final Fantasy IX, who's great. I only know him in the context of Kingdom Hearts, but I really like him a lot. So, this is kind of like picking your weapon at the beginning of Kingdom Hearts 1 in a way. They each prioritize a specific stat. This isn't where you choose like your leveling and like your focus per se. It just gives you one initial like start to your stat. Yeah, one like boosted stat right at the beginning of the game that makes it a little easier. So there's this one has a handguard, so this will give you defense. This looks almost like a staff. You can use it to perform unusual attacks. And this will give you like a plus one to magic. And this one will give you a plus one to attack, which I'm going to choose. Like last time I played, I think I chose the defensive sword, and then I ended up going with like an attack focus. So I'm going to be doing a little differently this time around. Gauge in the bottom right is the HP gauge. You lose HP when damage is taken and battle is over when HP reaches zero. Blue gauge in the bottom right is the MP gauge. It holds a mysterious power that is not yet available. When you approach a target, a yellow mark will appear. Press X to attack. Approach and attack Cypher. There we go. After hitting an attack, an enemy with an attack, continue to attack to unleash powerful combos. Press X successfully. In succession. Counter an enemy attack with your own to parry and nullify the attacks. This action is also useful in a defensive stance.
Come on. Quit playing around and fight.
Alright. So now it's an actual fight, and I realize that my face is in front of the information box. That will display, like, information, obviously, like, you know, important stuff pertaining to the fight, like if you had to defend, or, if you had to, like, protect yourself or, defend a certain character, or, like... The game mixes up their variety at times, kind of, like, it's not just beat the boss, sometimes there's, like, other moves to it. There we go. Trying to do air combos. There we go. I don't think you, like, if you lose a Cypher, it doesn't change how the game goes.
Tournament decides.
Whoa!
What was that?
The thief?
So we can't hit it. Gotcha. Captured you.
We have come for you, my liege. Huh?
Yeah, that is an example of the reaction command at work. It's usually kind of basic stuff like that, but It'll give you certain advantages in combat when you can actually hit the enemy. It's kind of like the Heartless in Kingdom Hearts 1. We couldn't damage it without the Keyblade.
It's no use. What?
Speaking of Keyblades.
What? What is this thing?
Defeat mysterious enemy. So you normally only have like a combo of like two or three. So like the fun thing with those guys is that you can actually use reversal to extend your combo. I was talking about orbs. Green is health. Yellow is money.
What's this?
I was his first customer after he took over the shop. So we took a picture together.
It's a really nice photo. Oh.
Hey, you just said photo.
So, Roxas, tell us about the picture thief.
Not much to say. The pictures were just lying there.
Then how do we prove we weren't the ones who took them? It's a girl.
You look happy, Roxas.
Do not. So, like, anybody else notice that all the stolen pictures are of Roxas?
Oh. So that's why everyone thought it was us.
And Cypher didn't go around accusing us after all.
Are they really all of me?
Yep. See?
Look.
Right? Every single one. Wouldn't it be weird if the thief wanted to steal the real Roxas or something?
Come on, get serious. Why would anyone want to steal a bonehead like Roxas?
Oh, thanks. Where am I? Who's there? Who are you?
Restoration at 12%.
Organization miscreants. They found us.
But why would the nobody steal photographs?
Both are nothing but data to them. The fools could never tell the difference. We are running out of time. Namine must make haste.
Where am I? What happened to my home? My island, Who are you?
They will come at you out of nowhere. As long as you continue to wield the Keyblade.
Hey, why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
Sora, go with them. Especially if you want to find your friends.
Name's Goofy.
I'm Sora. I'll go with you guys.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
But the boy is a problem. He found one of the keyholes.
A key?
Keyblade? A Keyblade.
Twig boy.
What was that about? Oh. Sorry about that. Thanks.
Do you guys think we'll always be together like this?
I sure hope so.
Huh? Where did that come from?
Well, you know, just thinking out loud.
Well, I doubt we could be together forever. But isn't that what growing up's all about? What's important isn't how often we see each other, but how often we think about each other. Right?
Get that off a fortune cookie?
That's it. No more ice cream for you. Man, today's turning out to be a drag.
Maybe because of yesterday's memory thief.
Nuh-uh. You know what it is? We don't want summer vacation to be over, that's all. So, how about this? We all go to the beach. Why do we go to the beach? Because we haven't gone once this entire vacation.
I feel
blue
that.
Blue seas, blue skies. Let's just get on the train and go. No? Oh, come on. Maybe you forgot, but we're broke.
I feel that even
Maybe
more.
Maybe you forgot, I'm smart.
Approach the light for the save reaction command to appear. Press triangle to open the save menu that allows you to save your game. Alright. Yep. That is my one save file. In about 44 hours, I managed to accomplish a decent amount. Hopefully we'll be able to breeze through faster, but, like, we're almost already at the... Well, technically we've been playing for 33 minutes, but, we've been at this almost for an hour, and I want to keep going. I want to, you know, kind of complete Twilight Town a bit. I'm okay with this being a longer episode, per se. I might break it up. Actually, this seems like a good spot to break it up, so when I'm editing this, I'll probably, you know, break it up here. But I'm not going to call quits on the stream until we finish Twilight Town, at least. There are many other save points besides this one. Make good use of them as they restore Roxas's HP and MP. Hurry up, Roxas! We're going to Market Street. Twilight Town map. A map of the area. Back alley. So, one cool feature is there is skateboarding now. Yeah, I don't know why they decided to add in this game. Like, it's... When you think about it, it's a little bit of a weird feature. I think it's, like, because this came out early 2006, I think, and the early 2000s was when, I think, you know, skateboard culture, I think it was bigger in the 90s and stuff, but, like, there was, like, the whole Tony Hawk craze and everything, so I think, like, they, not necessarily getting in on it, I guess they kind of were. They were just playing around with it. The thing with Kingdom Hearts is that it's very much what they, a lot of, like, the design philosophy behind is kind of, like, what do they think would be cool to do? And I think that was kind of it. Also, Kingdom Hearts 2 has a lot of, like, movement stuff. Like, this game has some of the most, like, has some of like the most fun mobility in this game. Like I talked about how much like I like gliding in Kingdom Hearts 1. This game has gliding later, but like also like just like a lot of fun ways to move around and get around the world, and this is just one of those ways. Looks like I can't go through now. Looks like it goes through, but I can't use it now.
Just 2 days to go. You and I have to make the finals. That way, no matter who wins, the four of us split the prize.
Okay, you're on. You two are gonna clean up.
Go get him.
It's a promise.
Now let's get to business. One ticket to the beach is 900 money. How much for four of us? 360 money. 3,600 money. I do math well. And 300 each to spend there. What's that for all of us? 1,200 money. A total of 4,800 money. To spend on what? Pretzels, of course. What else is there? Well, there's always watermelon. Duh, Hainer. Too pricey. They're like 2,000 money apiece. Pretzels it is. So, where were we? We need 4,800 money altogether, but all we have is... I've got 800. 650. 150. Sorry. That's 1,600. We need another 3,200. Let's find ourselves some odd jobs and earn some dough. We have till the train leaves to earn 800 money each. Meet at the station with cash in hand. Didn't he say he had it covered? Whatever, those pretzels are sounding pretty good. I had like the best pretzel at the Renaissance Fair, and like it was just so good. Like I didn't need any dipping sauce or anything, it was that good. The main menu can be opened with the options button. View status, money, change configuration settings. The menu cannot be opened during battle. Roxas' journal contains hints of what to do next in past events. So yep, status. Roxas, level 1, experience 6, next level 34. He's got 6 strength, 6 magic, 2 defense. His HP, MP, AP. Don't know about bonus level, I don't know what that is. Played in this game for years and I still don't know. He has no resistances what to speak of. This is his journal. Summary. Hainer's plan was for everyone to earn money for the beach by doing odd jobs. Objective. Meet at the station with some money. And this is config where we can change everything. Field camera. I think I'll keep it on auto. If I need to, I will. Change it. So yeah, this is just like quality of life changing stuff. Little details about your controls and everything. Hainer said he'd take care of things, but I knew something like this would happen. You can start work at this board or at the tram common board. Hainer went up the hill. It looks like he's waiting at the station plaza. It seems he's got some things to do, so I'm going to try hard too.
I'm making weapons for the struggle tournament. Sorry, but I'm too busy now to run the shop.
This is the first time I've been put in charge of the shop. I'm still learning the ropes, so bear with me a little longer, okay? It's hard work delivering letters along the slope. I wish I could find someone to help me. Want to help me put on a performance? I'm hiring some part-time help. So, there are 6 jobs in total that we can do. I'm going to talk to everyone in this area first. Station Plaza, Tram Common. It's locked and won't move. So, if you want to, I think after you complete one job, you can just go up this way and talk to Hainer and continue on. I want to do all the jobs, and actually, I think if you get 1,000 money, you actually gain a boost to your AP later on in the game, so it's actually really, it's better to do more. I have to move those items into this garage. I posted a help wanted ad, but no one's come yet. So yeah, those are like the three basic jobs we have right now. I don't know, it's just fun to talk to people right now, and... Okay, so sort of spoiler for Kingdom Hearts, not really. Kingdom Hearts 3. They kind of done away with the whole NPCs not having voices. Like, everyone has a voice actor now, and it's cool because it's like quality of life and it's very nice. But on the other hand, I kind of miss being... I'm gonna miss being able to do, like, Donald and Goofy's voices and stuff. As bad as they are, it's a lot of fun. So we're gonna start with Grandstander. Impress the crowd by keeping the ball afloat. Don't let the ball touch the ground. The longer the ball is kept in the air, the more money you will earn. If only it were this easy in, like, real life to earn money, you just hit a ball in the air a little bit. I think I'm getting there. This used to be like the hardest one for me. Here we go. I'm actually doing pretty good here. Now, I don't know if like there's like a max limit you reach where you like end up breaking the ball or not, but... Speed through this one here. Wow, you're the best. Receive 50 money. Okay, so yeah, I think that's the max you can get for that one. Cargo climb. Looking for someone to carry some stuff. Anyone will do. You're not really carrying it. Take the cargo to the garage on the top of the hill. Push the cargo with a weapon. If pushed at the right time, the cargo will move further ahead. The cargo could be dangerous, so be careful. Yeah, eventually it'll kind of like go up in the air, and it's like about... There we go. I don't have the time limit, so I can't see where... How fast we're going, I don't feel good about this. Clear. Not bad. Receive 30 money, okay. And now this is actually my favorite one because we get to use a skateboard. I've never actually skateboarded before, and when I tried one time, I fell and hit my head, so I never did that again. Deliver all the letters. I know how to complete the job quickly to earn lots of money. Here we go. This always happens. Here we go. Thanks, you're a big help. Awesome, 50 money. Actually, I'm going to look up the requirements for getting the money, just so I know. The promoter of the struggle battle sure works people hard. It's hard putting up posters, Trim Common is huge. Yeah, alright. right, so, okay, so you need to earn 2,000 money total, and you'll get, like, some extra AP and stuff. I'm stacking up on merchandise now. Lots of people will come to see this struggle, and I don't want to run out. Sorry, I'm old, so I closed my shop. I'm enjoying my life now with my cat, Chiro. You need money to buy items. If you ever need some cash, you could come check out the board here.
This place is a mess. Who's going to clean all this junk up?
Alright, so we're going to do all six of the money missions, and then I'm going to... Alright, so we're going to start with Junk Sweep. Get rid of all the junk. Hitting junk, try to aim for other piles. The less swings you take to get rid of the junk, more money you make. There we go. I probably could have been more efficient with that. I want to get the 2,000 money limit, because once you do, it'll move you on to the next quest.
Passable, I'd say!
I feel so bad for, like, all the old people I voice, because, like, it just sounds like they're hurting. Oh, this is one of the cool things you can do with the tram. Just jump up on that, it's so cool. I don't know, I wish I was, like, agile as Sora and, like, Roxas and Riku and stuff. Watch out, there are bees in there. Where could they come from? I posted an ad on the job board to exterminate them, but no one's replied. Are there actually bees in there? Oh, yes, there is. Oh, hey, it's a little extra way. It's a way to get some extra money. That's cute. Gosh, I could see, like, some poor challenge runner going and playing this game, and then, like, some horrible challenge would be, yeah, just grind the bees for money. Yeah, right now, actually, there is no way to grind for, XP. The game's actually kind of strict about that. So yeah, that hints you at what the next, game type is. I mean, mini game. No money, unfortunately. For the go! Stop running away. There we go. That did not go at all as well. Alright. 30 minute money, I can do that. This one's hard. Well, it's not hard. It's actually the one I had the most fun with, but, like, you have to be efficient about it. Put up posters, search for available areas, and press the triangle button. Alright. We gotta put up 20 and a certain amount of time. And the thing with this one is that, like, like I said, Kingdom Hearts 2 has, like, a lot of mobility. Going from, like, Kingdom Hearts to, like, my old save file, which I occasionally get on to, like, try to beat the bonus bosses, because I still haven't beat any of the bonus bosses yet. That save file, it's, like, there's, like, so much mobility you have that it's actually a little frustrating going from that to this, where I have, like, only half the same abilities you do. Alright. So it's really cool, the whole, like, you know, you can kind of, like, jump to areas with this. Oh, I am so not getting an efficient time. This is so bad. Like, it's funny, like, I don't know if it's just because, like, I'm, like, I actually have to record and do this, but, like, I used to be so much more efficient at this than I was. Like, I got a good system going, too. Although, like, even if, like, I had gotten a good time, I feel like I just did, like, the... Oh,
fantastic, I owe you one.
Oh, wow, I actually did good. I guess that's the moneymaker. I didn't even mean to make that joke. That's awesome. So, actually, I'm going to go back to the usual place, because I just looked at the time, and I actually have an early day tomorrow. So, I'm calling this a little break. So, Twilight Town, I was not able to get done in one sitting. Normally I can, because, like, Twilight Town, like, the PlayStation 2 version of Kingdom Hearts 2, super long load times. Oh my gosh, so long. Like, I kind of take it for granted until I started playing Kingdom Hearts 3, where, like, I started to realize, oh wow, hey, guess what? Long load times, they, like, fixed it up really good for this game. Like, I'll be able to explain it more when we actually, you know, start visiting other worlds and everything. But, like, this, like, Twilight Town used to take forever. Like, whenever I started a new game, you know, I would end up spending, like, 2 or 3 hours, in Twilight Town. And, you know, there are easier ways to just kind of breeze through it, and I'm taking my time with this because I want to. But I guess, you know, basically, I'm taking longer than I thought I would, but I'm not worrying about that. I realize, like, so this is kind of like my conclusion here, quick one, because I'm going to be cutting this up to be putting it back together, so that way there's, like, some sort of continuity and flow. But, like, one thing I realized with Rechain of Memories, specifically when I was playing as Riku, is that I was rushing through the game, and I didn't like that. It wasn't fun, and I want to take my time more. So that's what we're going to do. I will be back in a second. Like, it'll just cut, go boom, boom, boom. So, cool, have fun, see you in a sec.